Robbins. I'm the best-selling author of The 5-Second Rule, and as an overwhelmed mother of three, I used to have a never-ending to-do list that stressed me out for days. You know, the research says that 41% of the stuff on our to-do list never gets done. Well, that was me, which is why I created the undo list. This is where I teach you to remove the stress and write less on your to-do list. So when I got Bob's message begging me to help his wife, Dawn, I just couldn't resist. Check this out.
Hi, Mel. I am Dawn's husband, Bob. She is a wonderful wife and a wonderful mother and a wonderful human being in general. But yeah, these lists are just, they're not good. She makes them all the time, and I don't think any of us really put much stock into them because we know that most things aren't going to get done. She doesn't just have a to-do list. She also has to-do laundry baskets. And we always know that when laundry baskets get bought and things get put in them, they'll be in there forever because they are never coming out. And I've tried to tell her just kind of kick back, relax, and get used to losing, but she doesn't seem to want to do that.
I've been making to-do lists for as long as I can remember. Every day I have at least 20 items on my to-do list, and I might get 2-4% of those items done. I do feel very overwhelmed. My family thinks that I do too much. When I do get overwhelmed, I will freak out and I yell at them, and they know that's how I deal with my stress. But I'm just trying to be a better wife, mom, friend, volunteer. I'm addicted also to buying to-do lists. When we go to the store together, my youngest daughter will slap my hand and say, don't buy that. But I always think of that if I find the right paper, it will help me with my to-do list. I know it's, and my family is laughing at me.
If you think you can help her, good luck. It will be a challenge for you.
Oh my God. Don't you just love Dawn? Oh my gosh. Dawn, you're all of us. And I love that you're buying pretty paper.
Yes.
But is it really helping?
No, it's not. No, it's not.
So you started storing your to-do lists in baskets?
Yes, when, you know, company was coming over and I'd have to-do list and things to do, and the kids were little about 15 years ago, so I just started throwing them in baskets and putting them away so no one could see it, and then bring it back out when they're gone.
Oh my gosh. You know, when I saw the photo of the piles of baskets, it's cute. I actually have to give my mom credit for this because she was asking me, what's on the show tomorrow? And I was like, oh, this cute woman, Dawn, and she makes these to-do lists and she puts them in laundry baskets, and she goes, those aren't to-do lists. Those are diaries of her stress. And Julia, you're the opposite of your mom.
Yeah.
You're the most organized person in the house. What's your theory for why you think your mom has all these to-do lists?
You know, I'm not really sure, because, I mean, I have a lot of things to do as a high school student, and I mean, it's not anywhere near close to the things that she does, but she just can't ever seem to get everything done.
But I get a lot done.
You know, you get a lot, but it's just like a really tiny fraction of the very long list that she has.
So what's the list that you have that stresses you out the most?
Let me see. Well, this is
okay, do you want me to hold something? Here, I'll hold something.
Well, this is a list from 2018, and there's like
2018?
January 5th.
December 5th.
Oh, yeah. She yells when she gets mentioned.
So this is next week. So next week I have a booster meeting. I'm gonna miss two meetings because I'm
a booster meeting?
Yes.
My husband is the head of our booster club in the high school. We don't.
Me too.
You too?
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. Yeah. Okay. And we don't even have kids in the high school anymore, for crying out loud.
I'm gone. When she graduates, I'm gone.
Christopher, did you hear Dawn?
You leave.
Yes.
You leave.
I'm on my way out.
Okay. Well, you know, I love this because this is one of the pretty paper ones.
Yes, it's not
color. So everyone can
though.
See. It's not color, so yeah. It's not good enough. Okay.
Yeah. No.
So, you know, here's what I want to do because I really want to help you. And you've got a ton of stuff going on.
Sure do. Yeah.
So, here's the thing I want you to do. First of all, this is the habit we're going to undo. Okay, you ready? Number one, my mom's right. These are not to-do lists. Mm-hmm. These are diaries of all the things you're stressed about.
That's true.
Yes. Mm-hmm. I often, you'll hear me on social media, call it a brain dump.
Yes.
It's a long list of everything that's on your mind. This is what we call a stress diary. So from now on, don't call these to-do lists. You're just making a stress diary. You're just dumping everything out. That's fine. It's cool. It's a super good tool to use. The second thing is, for an actual to-do list, here's what I want you to do.
Okay.
When you wake up in the morning and you have your cup of coffee, you're going to make a list with just five things on it.
Okay.
That's it. Anything else that's not a priority for today, dump it in your stress diary.
Okay.
Okay? And that can go in a laundry basket, it can go in the garbage can, it doesn't matter where it goes, okay. But it is not your to-do list, because if you do that, it'll become your ta-da list, and you'll get it done if you just got five things on it.
Thank you.
All